first shot here. Couple of hits in four trips last night. First offering on the way. Now he lifts a high pop-up, drifting into foul territory on the right side. A lean, and he's got it! Oh, he picked it right out of the first base dugout, and that's the first out of the inning. Jordani Valdespin will stride in now. Two hits for him, including a home run in last night's contest. Now a hard hit ball back up the middle. A dive, but he can't knock it down. It's through for a base hit. Alberto Trujillo will stand in for the first time here. He's ready. Now the pitch. Bounce toward the hole and through into left field for a base hit.
Ball club just put together, you can't let them respond with a big inning of their own. But here they are with two on now and trying to answer right back.
Sets the 2-2 pitch. Now a ball hit back up the middle. Oh, he has some trouble with it. And now, fortunately, they will get an out here. Riley Green will dig in. He popped out in foul territory his first time. Now the first pitch. Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0. Here's the pitch. Now a swing and a ball lofted down the right field line and fairly deep. Portillo is out near the wall as he pulls it in for the second out. Riley Green will dig in again. He popped up in his first plate appearance and flew out last time around. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. The 1-0 pitch. 2-0. And this is something we've seen a lot from him recently. He's worked his way into another good hitter's count.
Yeah, it's not unrelated either. When you're going good at the plate, usually means you're being selective and you're not getting yourself out. When that happens, you'll find yourself in these kind of counts. Let it fly right here.
Hammered the other way to deep right field. And that one is out of here. Planted into the right field bleachers. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. 12 home runs for him now thus far as they extend the lead to 5-0. Skipper's out of the third base dugout on his way toward the mound. And a change is forthcoming as that's going to do it for his starter here this evening. Lorenzo Portillo will stand in. He's singled and popped out in his first two at-bats. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. And indeed it will. He throws him out at first, and the side is retired. Five innings have been no problem as he's got the shutout working. We're through five here at the ballpark, and Round Rock is out in front, 5-0.
Hey, we got one.
Justin Bohr will stand in now. He flew out in his first time around and then was a strikeout victim last time. Oh, double play ball to second. 4-6-3. It's a double play, and the inning is over. Eli Mateo is on the pitch now as he'll take over to start inning number 7. Riley Green will stand in yet again as we flash you back to the middle innings. This was a turning point here, a solo home run that was really one of the key at-bats of the ballgame to this point. Ball hit high and foul down the left field line. It's strike one. Bases are empty, one man out. The pitch. Goes the other way as this is lined to left. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. Miguel Rojas will stand in to start out their half of the eighth with that starter still out there. And he's definitely been a tough nut to crack.
No, he's been dominant all game long. And I think part of it is that he got himself a nice lead early on. allowed him to not really worry about making a mistake. It's been free and easy the whole way through. I want you to watch this throw here. You know, this isn't in the dirt. It's not in the sun. It's right there, but he just drops it. No real explanation for it, just a bad air.
Riley Green will stand in. He homered back in the fifth inning of this one. Now here's the first pitch. Now look out as that pitch sends him tumbling to the ground. Seemed to quicken his delivery to the plate on that last pitch.
Well, you got to remember, the slide step does two things for you. It gets the catcher the ball quicker so he can throw a guy out, or it will hold the run.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. So it's no runs on a hit, no errors, and a man left. Bottom part of the order, 7, 8, and 9, due up in the bottom of inning number 9. The Express leads it 5-1. Lorenzo Portillo will dig in now, and he'll do so representing the tying run.
Yeah, and you're not too worried about this guy jumping the yard on you here and tying the ball game. But if he does find a way to get on base, things get a whole lot more interesting.
Oh, and he can't come up with it. And the throw won't be in time as he'll be able to beat out the recovery throw at first. Good performance offensively for this bunch, but out of everyone, I think we should single out.
Inside the Show with Justin Allegri.
Happy Friday, baseball fans. Before the weekend series get underway, here are the highlights from Thursday's action. Starting out west in the American League, the Texas Rangers matched up against the Minnesota Twins at Target Field. And it was the Rangers who came away victorious, 6-0. Colby Lewis was dominant throughout the game, tossing a complete game one-hitter for the win. As of today, the Twins are in last.
Inside the Show with Justin Allegri.
Good morning, baseball fans. Great Sunday action lies ahead, but first, here's what happened in Major League.
Eric Campbell will get his first cuts here with two gone now and a runner at first. Ready now on 1-1. Runner goes for second. Hit and runs on here, and it's going to work to perfection as that's into the vacated area of base hit. Riley Green will stride forward now, looking to keep that hit streak alive. Currently at 6 games entering play. First offering on the way. And this is lined into left field for their first hit of the ball game. Andres Gonzalez will stand in, back in the lineup after getting the night off yesterday. Now a throw over to first. Runner back safely. Now the first pitch. He's running toward second. It's outside. The throw way late, and he's in there easily at second. Wilfredo Tovar will stand in here, looking to keep the inning alive with two gone now in the top of the second. Full count offering on its way. On the ground towards second. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Nothing across here this half of the inning. We'll go to the bottom half of inning number two. The 51s are in front here, 1-0. Riley Green will stand in. Base hit his first time around. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground towards second. Throw gets him, two down. Riley Green will dig in here. 1-for-2. He's singled and grounded out so far. Now a swing, and the barrel of the bat breaks in two that time. And he'll find a way to dodge the shrapnel out there to make the play for route number two. Oscar Jimenez will stand in again. He's flown out in each of his first two plate appearances thus far. Now here's a ground ball that'll get by the mound and into center field for a leadoff single. Here comes the manager out of the first base dugout heading for the mound. And it looks as though that's going to be all for his starter here tonight. Dwayne Dages will be the first to stand in against the new pitcher as he'll do so with a runner at first and nobody out. Oh, a double play ball to second. 4-6-3, and they turn the double play. Riley Green will stand in now in what could be a real make-or-break situation.
You think at this point you have to get something out of this inning. The further you get into that bullpen, the tougher it's going to be to claw back from this deficit.
Off the plate and away there. 1 ball, no strikes. The 1-0 pitch. Swing, line, drive. That's going to be trouble. And that two-run lead could be in real jeopardy. It's extra bases. And the runner is in from second. And he will score as well. A huge job to come through there, and this ball game is tied here late.
Boy, and as a pitcher, that's the last thing you wanted to see right there. Base hit, two runs score to tie this game up. You're still in trouble with the guy out there on second base, and man, is he fired up.
Jake Smolinski will dig in, needing to find a way to get that go-ahead run in from second base. Tomas Tellez will have a chance here in a crucial spot with the go-ahead run just 90 feet away. Matt Dendecker will stand in, and it's a bullpen game now. Both starters out as we begin inning number 8.
Yeah, both starters are out, and since we're tied, both starters not going to be involved in the decision.
Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. Dwayne Dages will dig in now, hitless in his two at-bats so far. Now here's the pitch. Swing, hard hit ball to second. On to first, and this will remain a tie ball game as the inning is over. Pretty painless half of the inning, all told. Home half of the 8th straight ahead, and we are tied 2-2. Eric Campbell will dig in. He homered back in the fourth. The 1-2. Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground to second. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. Riley Green will have a shot now to bring that winning run in, but we'll see if they decide to go after him or not. Here's the first pitch. Now a ball hit pretty well to left, but this is going to wind up in the seats foul. The 0-1. Now this is lined into right center. He comes through. Around third and being waved on home. And the winning run will score as they walk off with a 3-2 victory.
Mom for that one. What a great at-bat here as he just comes through in the clutch and drives home that winning run from second base.
Not a lot of offense to go around in this one, but what offense we did see came from this man's bat. He's our top player of the game.
And he stepped in knowing the game was on the line, and he was still aggressive.
Everybody.
And then briefly, let's take a look at the two starting pitchers who get the assignment here. In the lineup after getting the night off yesterday. Now the first pitch. I'll hit sharply as this is pulled into right. Catch is made here in right, and here comes the runner from third. And the run will score from third to make this a 1-0 game. So So problems out there in right field, as this is going to wind up going as an E9. Riley Green will stand in, a lineout victim his first time.
Riley Green.
Come on, sitting on something here. What do you say? Hey, keep swinging that hot bat, kid.
First offering on the way. Oh, had him chopping at that one. It's nothing in one.
Now, he's probably lucky he didn't make contact on that one.
He's set, now the pitch. Here's
a swing. That's way gone.
Oh, man. Way out of here. So it's a three-run shot to straightaway right field. Number 18 for him on the campaign as they move on top 4-0.
That was killed. Swirl.
Yeah, Warner. We'll lead things off here in the home half of the fourth. Pitch on the way. Pitches away, but it's swung on and grounded to second. Throws in time, and that's out number one.
The left fielder, number three, Andy Boyd.
Riley Green will dig in. Had a three-run homer his last time. Not fooled there as this ball's hammered out to deep right field.
Yep.
And this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. His second home run of the game, and it's now 5-3.
Well, it seems to me like we've seen this before. His second home run of the ball game, and it would seem to me that he hit that one harder than he did the last one, so he's definitely locked in.
Billy Burns will stand in again. A couple of ground outs for him on the ledger in his two trips so far. Pause, now the pitch. This is popped high in the air toward the right side of the infield. Oh, and he misses it.
Wait, what's going on?
And the throw will go to second as they get the force out. Andy Hoyt will stand in for the third time now, still without a hit, so that streak could be in a bit of jeopardy.
And I think that's in the back of his mind, but it's not something he's really focused on. He just wants to get up there.
Sorry to interrupt, but the play has been made for the third out. Inning over. RJ
hi, person. Can you say hi?
He'll start the sixth inning on the mound. Riley Green will come forward now in what could be an at-bat that goes a long way toward deciding this ball game.
And they better be careful, too, because they haven't gotten him out yet. So this is no small task.
Now a line drive, and that may be enough to break our tie. That's down for extra bases. And the go-ahead runs across to score from second as they take the lead 6-5. And he will scramble back to third, but get there safely.
What is going on?
And they'll get the out here as he's run down between second and third. Chris Bassett will get the ball here as he looks to get the final out in the top of the seventh. Riley Green will stand in again as he looks for home run number 3 in the ball game as we flash you back here to his second home run. This was back in the fifth inning as he has the long ball working in his first few at-bats. And this will get by him at third. Down the line, it's a fair ball. And the runner is in from second. Now it's cut off. The throw to the plate. And it's in time, and he's out at the plate. So one runs across, but the second one is cut down trying to score. So a run on two hits, no errors, and a man left. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eighth coming up. And Round Rock is out in front, 8-5. Hideki Hara is on out of the bullpen now as he'll take over to start the bottom of the eighth. Well, the bats were certainly working in this one, but out of everybody, I'd say this man most deserves to be our top player of the game.
Yeah, I think in the end, this really could have been anybody's award.
Show with Justin Allegri.
Welcome, baseball fans, to our Wednesday edition of Inside the Show. Let's jump right into Tuesday's action. Starting out west in the American League, the rain.
Riley Green will stand in here for the first time, looking to pick up that runner from second with two away here.
Hey, nice and patient.
Now the first pitch. Here's a swing, and oh, man! Way out of here! Well, what a special way for him to start out his Major League career. His first Major League hit is also his first Major League home run. Not many players can claim that.
And as a player, you're anxious to get those first out of the way as quickly as possible. So safe to say that collecting your first hit and home run with one swing of the bat, well, that's pretty sweet. Let's hope they can get out there and claim that ball for him as a souvenir, because he's going to want to keep that in his trophy case.
And how about that? Riley Green has got himself his first big league round tripper. We'll have to wait and see how many more of these he can mount in his career, but for now, I'm sure he's happy to say he's got his first.
Well, I think that any kid who's ever dreamed about playing this game dreams exactly this, watching the ball disappear over the fence, then circling the bases in a big league ballpark. I'm sure he was practically floating as he jogged the bases. He'll be replaying that at bat over and over. You know his phone's going to blow up. He's going to be calling his mom, his buddies.
Throw to first is in time, but meanwhile, the runner is in to score.
Yeah, unless he was going on his own down there at third, they were using that contact play where you're told wherever and whenever the ball's hit, you're off and running. You're not even paying attention to what's going on. You've got to go. They love to play an aggressive style on the bases.
Meanwhile, this ball gets down. It's a base hit. One run scores. And the second run will score as well.
Yeah, and he had his first major league hit earlier in the game. How about a two-hit game to start things out? Attaboy.
Now here comes Bud Black up out of the Friars dugout on his way to the mound. And a change is forthcoming, as that'll be all for Ian Kennedy. And a sure sign that trouble is afoot, as there is already some action in that bullpen now. We're just in the second inning. Will Nieves will lead things off here with his guys down 7 in the early going. Steve Lyons, how do you come back from a deficit like that?
Well, I think slowly. I mean, yeah, ideally a 10-run inning would be great, but you've got time on your side. You don't need to try to get it all back at once. Just peck away. A couple runs here, a couple runs there. Get yourself into slam range. That's 4 runs down.
Yonder Alonso will dig in. Drew a walk his first time around. Now here it comes. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. And indeed it will. He throws him out at first, and the side is retired. Riley Green will try it again. He homered back in the first inning of this one. First offering on the way. This is hit down the right field line, but it's going to get out of play for strike one. Nobody out, runner on first. Set, now the pitch. And this ball's heading for the seats down the right side as the count will move to 0-2 now. Come set, now the pitch. And did he hold up in time? A look down, and no, he went around. It's strike 3. Will Nieves will dig in. Popped out his first time. Runners lead from first and third. Here's the pitch. Now a ground ball for Andrus at short. This could be 2. Relay to fielder. It's a double play, and that'll end the inning. Riley Green will stand in here, but before he does, let's take you back to the very first inning. This was a 2-run home run right out of the gate that really got these guys off to a fast start. Now here's the first pitch. Pitch lined into left field, and for the third time tonight, he's got a base hit. Action now in the Padre bullpen, as it looks like a right-hander's getting loose out there. Matt Kemp will stride in. He singled in his last plate appearance. 1 run on 3 hits. And 2 errors thus far for San Diego. He's ready now. The pitch. Swinging a little tapper out in front of the mound. 1 there. Return throw is in time. And what do you know? They do get the double play.
Well, that's the absolute definition of a pitcher's pitch right here. Especially in a double play situation. I mean, not only is this pitch down, I don't even think it's in the strike zone. And that's an easy double play.